So my name is John. I run the Asian Amateur YouTube channel. Can you name the second best Taiwanese company after TSMC? None of you can. Probably Foxconn, which sucks. So like, I would say that TSMC basically pulls every technical talent from Taiwan. If you are the smartest person in the room in Taiwan, you automatically basically get assigned to electrical engineering, to semiconductors, to TSMC. Within Taiwan, every supplier, chemical supplier, equipment supplier, machine supplier, even nuts, bolts, and everything, has to be within 3 hours distance of every TSMC fab in Taiwan. So if anything breaks down in a fab and they need a call about it, the supplier has to respond within 1 hour, no matter what the time, and they have to ship over a replacement part within 3 hours. That cannot be done, imagine, if Intel and Oregon, right? So all three of TSMC's big production facilities are within 3 hours of one each other. And that's very critical to making sure that they keep producing, that the line never stops. TSMC long wanted Apple as a customer, and Apple was worried about rising direct competition between themselves and their biggest component supplier. However, Samsung offered a product that TSMC could not match. It was a very thin packaging option where you stacked dynamic RAM on top of the chip CPU with a wire bond connecting the two together. It was suitable for a very thin phone, and TSMC needed that option to steal away Apple. So when Dr. Jiang returned, he helped develop something called CoWoS, an advanced packaging that connected together chips using a silicon interposer, kind of like a PC motherboard, but like silicon. CoWoS had been developed for NVIDIA, but it was very sparsely used. They barely used it, actually. It was like 40 units. And it was until TSMC produced a second generation version, which was very cheap. I think it was like 4 cents per unit. And Apple accepted this packaging solution for their next phone. Then to seal the deal in 2011, TSMC sent 100 R&D workers to Cupertino to work in secret on the next generation Apple A8 chip, while avoiding Samsung's patents. In 2014, TSMC entered the Apple supply chain, and their size and heft funded TSMC's future nodes and has pushed it into a technology leadership position. And CoWoS, in of itself, has gone on to power technologies like NVIDIA's H100 AI accelerator, which is right now at the heart of the ChatGPT revolution. So reflecting on like TSMC's actions today, I think there are a few things that really leap out at me. First, you have TSMC, which is, they stopped cutting costs. Their new CEO had put themselves in a place that there was causing them to lose their technological advantages. Morris Zhang literally came back and he basically just said, if you build it, they will come. And usually that doesn't work out, but this time it did. Second, that was the second classic case of the founder having more power than he probably should. But they couldn't say no to the founder, especially one as famous as him. Companies like Intel, that are many generations away from their founders, are at a risk of getting stale. And finally, it is a reflection, I think, of the importance of culture, right? Something that I've been thinking for a long time is these Western semiconductor companies have the same equipment, follow similar recipes, and hire the same smart people. So why does one succeed and the other fail? I think that's a very interesting question. And I've asked a lot of people, I talked to a lot of people in Taiwan, and I asked them one of the first questions, like if they're involved in this, I say, why is TSMC beating Samsung? Why is TSMC beating Intel? Why are they beating almost everyone except maybe SMIC? And they always give me this very squishy answer, which is like culture. It's always culture.
Yeah.
The generalization is that Samsung seniority is so important that when a problem starts at the bottom. So problems in semiconductors start from the bottom and ripple upwards. So if you do a layer in the node wrong, one of the processes have a problem, it might survive, but it might compound over time, right? Mm. There's 1,000 steps in a semiconductor node. And even if you get 99.9% yield on one step, if that compounds over time, you end up with something like 20% yield overall for the whole chip. Mm-hmm. So a tiny, tiny ripple becomes a tsunami over time. Mm-hmm. My current working theory is that in Samsung Foundry or whatever, mm-hmm. or Intel, or any other company, there is a problem that one of the process engineers sees, and he doesn't tell anyone. Mm-hmm. Keeps it a secret. And it goes ripples and ripples and ripples, and then finally, at the last second, when it's too late, They tell senior management. Senior management's like, oh no, what is this? Mm-hmm. And the chips don't yield.